Hello, student. So, maybe you've played my Albert Einstein rock, paper, scissors game, but here's just a little display of it. I'll choose the cat. And it's a really small, not very polished game where you try to beat Einstein at rock, paper, scissors. But today, we're going to build another game. So the way that we start this is we come up here to rename our project. Now I'm going to this design tab first, and we have to add a few things. Let's get a label to show instructions. And we're going to put them, just tell them to press the button to win. Now we need three buttons to represent our three shells. Hopefully you watched that video at the beginning. If you weren't familiar with the shell game, more than likely you probably were, but might not have known the name of it. I'll go ahead and now change the text of each of the buttons to 1, 2, 3, and we'll put in another label for the title. Okay, now we're going on to the code tab. Now we're going to start by making a variable. First, just go and take a look at these what are called toolboxes here. But I'm going to start by making a variable. A variable is a symbol or word that represents a number, kind of like in math. And I'm just going to start off by making that be 1. Now the next thing we have to do is what's called handle an event. So that's under UI controls, and drag out this on event thing here. And the event we want to handle is if one of our buttons is pressed. So we set it up that if our first shell is clicked, then we'll do whatever is in between, in that green area, kind of there. Ignore that message. Now, this is a game with winning and losing. So let's make sure we have those messages to display to the user. Back to the design tab. We have, the you win message, and I'm just going to give it an ID that we'll be able to recognize it by. You'll notice I keep changing the IDs. That's that way when later we're, showing and hiding and clicking things, it's easier to remember what was what. Now also, we gotta remember that we want these to start hidden, so we're going to go and select this hidden thing. Now, in our UI controls toolbox, and by the way, UI stands for user interface, we're going to find the show element command. This allows us to show the win message. Now, we'll go and do the opposite for the other two buttons. As in, we'll still make the shell 2 click, shell 3 click, but now for those, we want to go ahead and show the lose label, because we kind of decided that shell 1 had the item we're looking for. Now, we had a problem. If I pressed the incorrect button, and then a correct one, I got both messages. So let's use this hide element command, and hide the message that we don't want to see. And I'll put that in there. Now let's go and check. And now we've got, we've at least got the messages displaying one at a time. Alright, now I'm going to rename our variable to something more meaningful, call it winning shell, and I'm going to use something called a conditional. It's in the control toolbox. See the word if? It does whatever is between the blue if the part in the orange is true, and the orange is now what I'm going to type in here. So just if the winning shell was shell number 1, then we'll go ahead and hide the losing element and show the winning label. And now I type the first one in, but let's use the orange math toolbox command this time. So we go to the orange math toolbox, get out that command for that equals equals. And I'm still going to check just based on 1, since winning shell, we just started at 1, and that's all. So put in these conditions. And depending on whether our variable is equal to 1, that should affect which button displays a win and which ones display loss. So test that. Game still works. But it does not work at all if we change our variable to 2. Because it's only checking for 1. All those if statements are only looking to execute, to do what's in that blue area, if it's equal to 1. And since it's not equal to 1, well, it's not going to do anything. So let's click this plus button. That shows the word else. As in, do this, else, if this did not work, then do this. So what we want is, if the winning shell was 1, then show the win message. Else, show the lose message. So we're going to set this back to 1, because, you know, if it's 1, then we want to show. But let's test it with 2 now. So we're testing that else. If it was 2 and we clicked on shell 1, hold on, we gotta go ahead and show the lose message and hide the win message. And that's just with show elements and hide element again. Now let's change the conditions of our other buttons, so that each is checking for its own button, rather than all checking for 1, checking for 2 and 3. Add in those else's, and we're going to get the proper messages to show up. And now, all three of statement structures look pretty much identical. And since our variable is at, well, now 3, that's the only button that shows victory. Let's go and test that. All right, good. Now, that's cool, but it could be better. Because once we know what shell is the correct shell, we never lose. So let's go to that orange math toolbox again, and find this command for getting a random number. As you might guess, it's that one that's called random number. A lot of things like this are going to be kind of intuitive. So instead of having winning shell equal to 1, you notice how I drag in that orange box into that box, and I'm going to put two numbers in there for between 1 and 3, and that's going to get a random number between 1 and 3. Let's check. Okay, yeah. So every time we run our game, the pea or ball or whatever is hiding somewhere else. Now, you can follow along with my extra little design changes that I make here. I'm just going back to the design tab and making our app look a bit prettier. Remember, the shell game is a game for conning people, so you've got to dress it up a little. Alright, that's pretty much all the functionality I'm really going to go into in this tutorial. So I hope this showed you some of the things you can do with it. Remember, it's remember to go ahead and just